everybody, it's me, Emma Lightning, and welcome to another PSA Mega Review Countdown List video. Like I said, this one isn't going to be as long as the Partnership for Drug Free America Countdown, because that one was ridiculous. But this is actually my longest scripted video to date so far. As a PSA connoisseur, there's few things I love more than digging deep into specific organizations' archives to find lost treasures. And boy, I think I found a couple in here. Today, we are ranking every PSA that I could find from the Concerned Children's Advertisers. If you were a Canadian kid in the 1990s, or just a PSA fan, then I'm sure the CCA needs no introduction, as it was probably constantly played on TV all the hippo flippin' time. Founded in 1990, they only very recently shut down in 2017, so moment of silence. Fun fact, though, they actually changed their name to Companies Committed to Kids at some point, which, I mean, I'm not saying that's why they shut down, but you have to admit it is less catchy. I'm sure many of you already know that some of their more memeable ads have spread across the internet throughout the years, but they have a bunch of overlooked ads too. I was able to find 34 total. As always, these are my own personal rankings, not an objective measure of quality or effectiveness, and this is all in good spirit, so feel free to politely disagree. So prepare to be confused, charmed, and enlightened as we kick it off with number 34.
I'm not saying he's a loser or anything.
He's a dork.
Dork!
Yeah. I mean, no. We're not like, you know, we're having fun being cool, and he's just into different stuff. Well, I hang out with my friends mostly.
Girls think I'm cool.
Okay. But he's, you know, I'm into sports. Well, I used to be into sports, but now,
yeah, chicks dig me.
Well, I guess he has friends, too. You know, I think having girlfriends is okay, but, you know.
We like to party, right?
Guys like him, they don't like to party.
Like we do. You know, we're having a lot of fun.
Truth is, there's a million things to do that are more fun than sitting around getting stoned.
Yeah, we like to party. Did I say that already?
Think about it. A message from the Concerned Children's Advertisers.
So this is an interesting one to take the bottom spot, but I have a good reason for it. It gives me such flashbacks to a lot of those early entries on my partnership countdown, and obviously that is not a good sign. If I had to describe this one in one word, I'd probably go with annoying. It's annoying how inaccurately they're portraying stoners, for one thing. It's annoying how they're implying that smoking weed occasionally during parties automatically makes you a stoner. The stoners themselves are annoying. It's just unpleasant, this one. I also like how it's not okay for other kids to name call each other, but a bunch of adults acting superior for their drug PSAs are allowed to make fun of this group of 14-year-olds, no problem. Yeah, that's totally fine. But go off, I guess.
Lungo filaccio, triste sartaccio, fila, fila, ma che vuoi filare? Senza punta lago non può andare, troppo filo te l'ha fatto far, ed ora non puoi più filar. Hai filato giorno e notte con giacchette, pantaloni, sotto vesti e gonnelloni.
All right, real talk. Do little girls ever chase boys to try to kiss them? I feel like that's a very outdated thing, or maybe schools are just way more adamant about enforcing personal boundaries these days. So yeah, this one's a little creepy and a little outdated, but at the same time, I know it's supposed to be lighthearted. And also, I'm imagining what a gritty remake of this one might look like. It's shot in a first-person point of view, in the style of that The Chase fox hunting PIF, and then ending it with like snapshots of the boy covered in like lipstick prints, you know what I mean? And that is how you do a PSA parody.
When it's time to eat, use your head. Choose a variety of foods every day.
Let's go, let's go, let's go.
Get up and move your body at least 30 extra minutes each day.
So, did you all know that this PSA had an alternate version? I sure didn't, and I was not exactly thrilled to find that out, let me tell you. This one is weird. I included the head version on my What the Fuck PSAs review, if that tells you anything. I don't hate these, nor am I particularly creeped out by them. It's just one of the most random and strange gimmicks I've ever seen a PSA pull out, and that is really saying something.
Inches fake.
Home to Lola. Found this large male sports away trimming black fur.
You don't need a media monkey to make healthy choices. Think for yourself. A message from Concerned Children's Advertisers.
So to save you guys the time, I looked up the term media monkey and nope, it's not a thing. I've never heard that expression used before, and I guess maybe they thought that like it would catch on from this commercial. Obviously that didn't work out too well. Other than that, I'm still not entirely sure what they're going for here message-wise. Anyway, since this one doesn't have seem to have much to say, then neither do I. So let's move on to the next one.
Oh, there she is. She is such a loser.
I know.
What a geek. Get lost.
Words hurt. Don't be a part of it.
Now, those of you who saw my top 10 worst PSAs list way back in the day might recall that this one did indeed have a place on there. Now, looking back, I've always thought that I was a little too harsh on it. I don't think it's good. It's about as bland and cliche as a bullying PSA can get, and it has all the punch and impact of, like, an avocado. But I can't exactly condemn it either, because the number of bullying PSAs out there that I actually find good, I can probably count on one hand, so it's not necessarily this one's fault. Someday we'll try to dig a little bit and find out exactly why that is, but for now I think we can leave this one alone as just, you know, another stereotypical depiction of bullying. Good heart, bad execution.
Me? I'm just a TV. I mean, I'm not even human. You've got the remote control. You can change channels if you don't like what you're watching. You can flick me on and off, and on and off, and you... Whoa, I'm getting dizzy. You see, you're smarter than me. You get to choose from all kinds of neat stuff. Funny shows, nature shows, shows about people all over the world. Ouch! In real life, you know, that would hurt. You get to learn how to make stuff, how to draw stuff. Me, I don't get to do any of this stuff. I'm just the TV that plays it for you. Yep, I sure wish I was as smart as you. Did somebody get that cat off my head? Look at it this way. You can talk to your best friends, your mom or dad, about all the stuff you see on TV. And besides, you have choices. You've got books and sports, and you can go outside and play. Where is outside anyway? I'm just the TV. You're the smart one. Well, so long. See you next time.
I can imagine this as one of those horribly overplayed ads that you would see at least every other commercial break. I don't know if anybody can back me up on that, but while I do give it points for the CGI not looking horrifying, I don't think I would have paid much attention to this one when I was a kid. At least they're trying, though, and nowadays media will do anything to keep your attention on it, so this is a little bit refreshing. I just feel like somewhere there has to be a happy medium between shamelessly targeting every and any demographic you can, and being passive-aggressively lectured by a talking TV set. Am I asking for too much? Yeah, says the YouTuber who spends the majority of my free time consuming content online, but hey, I mean, I try, at least.
Stop! Come on!
What do you do when you find the needle?
Give me the alarm!
Tell a teacher!
Tell my mom!
Right! Tell somebody quick!
hurt you.
It can make you sick.
And it's sharp.
Oh, yeah. I almost forgot. What else?
Somebody has to stay.
I'm oldest. I'll stay.
I'll stay, too.
What's that?
It's needle. But look at it.
Remember, if you find a needle,
tell somebody.
This one is just so silly that I couldn't rank it any higher, but it's also hilarious, and I enjoy it too much to rank it any lower. It's cheesy, but not really in that Partnership for a Drug-Free America way, where you feel like it's being created by a bunch of adults to influence teenagers. This is just, it's for kids, and that makes the cheesiness more funny and enjoyable than annoying. Although I guess there could be a bit of fridge horror here if you're a conspiracy theorist and you think about how this seems like a well-disguised ploy for the government to continue to demonize drug users and recruit the children into being narcs for the war on drugs. But probably not, it's probably just a harmless safety PSA, and either way, I can laugh at it.
Kids, they're so cute, and forever learning new things. They're real copycats.
You better be good. Be dead.
Someone's watching your every action. Be aware. Be wise.
One of the criteria I had when ordering this list was how well do they show that they are, in fact, concerned children's advertisers. Like, some of them are obviously made for very young kids, and so even though I might find them kind of dull, I would still rank them higher up because of how well they would appeal to children. And this one, oddly, is aimed more at parents. I'm not sure what it's doing. If it was more like, hey kids, your parents might not always make the best decisions, so it's good to educate yourself about the world before trying something new, then that would be more in fitting with the CCA message. But it would also be kind of a weird message to put on TV, and I imagine parents would complain about it, so.
Stupid! You're such a loser! Come on, Four Eyes, give me your lunch money now! Give it to me before I smack you. You know what? You're the dumbest kid in the whole school. No wonder nobody likes you. I'm gonna beat the snot out of you. Yeah, come on, bring it. Come on, let's go. Are you afraid of me, eh? I'll take all you guys on. Let's go.
Bullies just want to show off. But if everyone just walked away, imagine how silly bullies would look. Walk away. Tell someone. Because bullies aren't bigger than all of us.
Again, with the world's most generic bully. I can be a little more forgiving with this one, though, since it's obviously just playing it up for the purpose of showing us how stupid it would look. So, that's a pretty good message. There's definitely nothing wrong with walking away when you can, because, yeah, a lot of verbal bullying in particular comes from just wanting to be, like, funny and edgy and get attention. Of course, then again, there are some people who are just gonna be like that no matter what, but this is a pretty good first approach. Once again, the real problem with this one is just how cliche and silly the bully is.
One potato. Two potato. Three potato. Four. Five potato. Six potato. Seven potato. More.
When it comes to important decisions, don't play games. Use your head instead. Give tough questions a piece of your mind.
So this one is apparently called Mo Funky. Don't ask me why it's called that, because I have no idea. Is that this kid's name? Are we supposed to infer that? Because that would suck. He seems like a cool kid. He does his own thing. He's a free thinker. But, you know, maybe this is a little unfair, but it is kind of hard to take something seriously when you got a guy chanting one potato, two potato in the background. And as much as I love the CCA for covering unique topics, sometimes I think there's a reason we don't make PSAs about everything. This one is literally just, think about your decisions. And that's it. Not only is that common sense, it's also very vague. I just feel like they could have made something a little more useful with their time.
Morning!
and Timmy. Want to hear what I'm gonna do to you today? First, you're gonna give me your lunch money. Then, I'm gonna find you at recess. And don't even think of playing soccer with us because you are such a loser.
Mom, I have something to tell you.
Wait, what are you doing?
There's this kid at school.
No one likes a kid who tells. Don't.
If you're being bullied, telling an adult is the best way to make it.
When I was writing out my notes for this review, I was surprised at how much personal shit this one ended up digging up for me, so sorry in advance if it gets a little heavy here. I know, I didn't expect the CCA to strike such a deep nerve within me either. Let me just say that theoretically, yes, just telling someone is a good idea. But historically, maybe it's not too effective. But I mean, what are we going to say? Hey kids, in this digital age, cyberbullying is pretty much impossible to control, and often it's easy for bullies to hide their tracks. Also, the fact that bullying is often more of a group effort to ostracize one person or certain types of people rather than one kid targeting another kid in front of everybody makes it a lot harder for authority figures to pin down and punish. So it's way more complicated than this PSA and generalized media makes it look. Good luck. Does that sound too cynical? I'm sorry, but even when I was a kid, this was never my experience with bullying. And I'm not saying it wasn't anybody's experience. I'm just saying I was a pretty easy target for people to pin down as weird. So it was more that my peers just didn't hide their dislike of me or make comments about me behind my back or just generally treated me as a weirdo rather than going out of their way to gang up on me. But the couple of times when things did escalate to them ganging up on me, I would end up losing my cool, which meant adults found out anyway, and suddenly we were all at fault. So how about we make some PSAs teaching kids not to be shitty instead? Or maybe encouraging them to develop empathy and reach out to weird kids? Again, I'm sorry if I got a little ranty here, but, you know, this one just struck a bit of a nerve with me.
You.
You can choose.
You can choose to be
you
alone.
You can choose to be a
choose
friend.
Choose to be your friend.
You can choose.
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 You can choose.
You can choose from 70 shades of blue.
70 shades.
You can choose
blue.
To ignore you.
You.
Choose.
You can choose to run wild.
You can choose not to watch.
You can choose to keep a secret.
To be shy.
You can choose to believe.
The dogs understand us.
You can choose to be bored.
Choose. You can choose to dream.
I.
You can choose.
You can choose.
Because you can.
You see what I mean? Again with the vague advice message. I don't even know if this one is really advice as much as it is, like, motivational statements, so I guess this is just motivational poster, the PSA. So points for originality, I guess. Maybe this did inspire some kids, and it's really refreshing to see just, like, a positive message being presented by itself and not being used to sell something, you know what I mean? It's a little depressing how that can be qualified as a point of praise, but I'm not trying to be cynical here, I'm just appreciating that this one seems to take on more meaning when it's compared to a lot of today's advertising. It's just a positive statement without the motive of selling something behind it.
Mommy, how was your work today?
Well, I had a good day. I was able to help someone at my school today, and that made me feel good.
How?
Well, a little boy in my class was sad, wasn't feeling good.
Was he crying?
A little bit. He feels like his mom is angry all the time.
Angry at the little boy?
That's the problem. He tries so hard to do his best, but his mom still gets angry.
But it's just a boy.
That's what I told him. When his mom is angry about her problems, it's not his fault. When she smashes things or yells or hits him, it's wrong. Because she is the adult, and adults know that yelling and hitting is wrong.
What is he going to do?
He's already done the most important thing.
He did?
Yeah, he told me.
Tell someone you trust when something is wrong. They want to help.
I think he had a good day.
Me too.
A message from Concerned Children's Advertisers.
To be honest, I don't know how well kids would get this one. I feel like it might go over their heads, even though it is pretty straightforward. That's not the problem. Somehow this one also feels like it's more aimed at parents to possibly explain to their kids what to do in these kind of situations. I don't know. I don't even think the little boy understands. He's probably too young. Which of course does beg the question, why is the mom confiding in her kid with this information anyway? Like, this is some other child's personal struggle, and I hope you're planning on getting some legal help, so it's not your place to talk about it, lady. But I'm probably reading too deep into it.
Hello, I have a lovely story to tell you all about a family of raccoons. One day they all went out to play in the sunshine, and baby raccoon saw some wild berries on a bush. But Mummy said, "Careful, baby, some berries are not for raccoons." Then he saw some big mushrooms growing by a tree. But Daddy said, "Careful, baby, some mushrooms are not for raccoons." And just like animals in the forest, you need to be careful too. Only take medicines or drugs if Mummy or Daddy says it's all right. And never take drugs from people you don't know. The next thing baby raccoon saw was a big apple tree. He asked his mummy, "Can raccoons eat apples?" Mummy said, "Yes, baby, you can have an apple. Remember, children, some things are good for you and some things are bad." Baby raccoon says, "Be careful, children, and only touch things that are good for you." And mummies like me want you to be careful, too. Bye-bye for now.
So this is one of those clearly aimed at preschoolers ads that I was talking about earlier. I find it silly, and this lady is kind of vaguely unnerving with just how she just barrels into the story.
Hello, I have a lovely story to tell you all about a family of raccoons.
The drawings are very nice, at least, and the story is a simple allegory for little kids to understand. So overall, even though it's a little bit bland, I don't mind this one too much. Yes, it's the great ice cream truck paradox. I mean, I suppose there aren't many kids who would try to chase after, say, a vegetable truck, but wouldn't that support their be healthy message a little more? Or, you know, maybe this is actually good, because they're saying when you're being healthy, you don't necessarily have to give up all treats like ice cream, but it's easier to reward yourself with them if you do stay in shape. So I'm gonna go with that. I like that message.
Food and activity working together, the body electricity. Let's start with the food that your body load. Gobble it up and send it on the road. The food gets to its destination. It's your gastric fascination. Your stomach acts like a wood burning fire. It burns your lunch up, that's your body's desire. You gotta balance food and activity working together, the body electricity. But there's a problem here that'll make your motor stop. When you just sit around, the engine will flop. So you gotta get moving for the work to be done. If you lay on a couch, you won't be any fun. If you just sit, your gut will be blue. If you sit and sit, you'll turn to goo. You gotta balance food and activity working together, the body electricity. The moral is you gotta balance the two. With good food and activity, you can make a healthy you. You gotta balance food and activity working together, the body electricity.
A message from Concerned Children's Advertisers.
If you know me, you know I'm a sucker for musical PSAs, no matter how corny they are. And this one is quite the earworm. I'm sure this one was also probably insanely overplayed back in the day. But I mean, hey, they wrote a whole song. And it's catchy. And they animated it. The animation's a nice touch, though I'm not sure why they have it printed on, like, a kid's t-shirt. I'm not sure what that's about, but... oh well. And I guess I'm a little biased in saying this, but who doesn't want to be electric?
Hi, Mike.
You know, I really don't get the big deal about drinking and drugs. It's like a lot of people don't give us any credit. Just because we're young, it doesn't mean we're stupid. I know what I want and what matters to me, and I'm not going to risk blowing it. It doesn't mean I'll never drink. It just means I'll be smart about it.
A message from Concerned Children's Advertisers.
Is it weird that I'm ranking this one this high? I feel like it might be kind of weird, but I just really like that this one isn't about condemning alcohol. It's not talking down to teenagers by acting like they can't make good decisions on their own, which is a trap that a lot of drug PSAs fall into, you have to admit. There's not much to say about it aside from that, but I just wanted to give it points for standing out a little bit, and that's kind of all I have to say. So this one makes me laugh, because obviously, like, Pokemon is still super relevant today, so I could see how this one could still be relatable. But I also think that in the light of Pokemon Go, this one becomes so much funnier. Like, for kids who are too young for smartphones, this is how you would play analog Pokemon Go. Just throw the cards around. Good luck. Don't get hit by a car. Go for it. And that would keep you very fit and very alert. So, two for the price of one.
How did it happen? How did I become an addict? I don't know. It seemed like it was the only thing that I could do, right? And I enjoyed it. I didn't have anything to worry about. But then it took over my whole life, and I hurt all my family. I didn't like the person that I became, and I didn't know how to stop. Today I know how.
A message from Concerned Children's Advertisers.
I had actually never seen or heard of this one before I made this list. I wouldn't have guessed it was a CCA ad either. It has very strong partnership vibes more than anything. And surprisingly, in this case, that's not bad. As I've mentioned before, I really like testimonial style drug PSAs. Whether this girl's an actress or not, I'm willing to bet she probably is since the script is pretty vague and typical, but I don't know for sure. It's pretty different territory for the CCA. Maybe that's why I'd never seen it before, because other people might not have recognized it either.
What's your thing?
Bugs.
Everybody's gotta have a thing.
My thing's sound effects. Here's a T-Rex.
Nobody's good at everything.
Everybody's good at something.
What's your thing?
Yet another one that's less of a PSA and more of just a motivational poster, but I like it a lot more because it has such good energy and it's more focused in its message. Plus, I love that your thing doesn't necessarily have to be something useful or a talent. It can just be something you're passionate about, and I think we all have those. They're having fun with it, these kids, and I don't know, it's just neat. It's neat to watch them. Additionally, that T-Rex noise will forever be the funniest fucking thing to ever air on television.
Listen up, mister, and you too, sister. Let's talk about something that's a real brain twister.
Drugs, drugs, drugs. Which are good, which are bad. Drugs, drugs, drugs. Ask your mom or ask your dad.
Drink a little water. Take the doctor's pill. Drugs can make you better when you're feeling ill.
Drugs, drugs, drugs. Which are good, which are bad. Drugs, drugs, drugs.
Yeah, I'll say it. This is a jam. I've been over this one, so I'm not going to dwell on it, but it never fails to get me hyped. Is that sad? I don't care. Do I think this one is effective in terms of a PSA? No, not really. But I don't think anybody thinks that. Even if this is the first time kids are hearing about drugs for some reason, it's probably not having much of an impact on them aside from, wow, drugs sound like a good time. It just reeks of the early 90s, and I love it.
Ever wonder what a bag of crack looks like? In the last 2 years, over 5,000 people in Canada and the U.S. have died from using crack or cocaine. Do yourself a favor. Think about it.
I don't know if anybody else got whiplash from going from the drug song to this. Sorry about that. This one is so unexpectedly dark for the CCA, but it works for sure. It's short, it's simple, and it's jarring, which are all good points for drug PSAs. Plus, the narrator's voice is really icy, and I think that just adds the extra little kick to it to really sell it. And we'll actually be hearing from her again later on the list, so keep your ears out for that.
Why do you think your mommy or daddy are always telling you, don't put that in your mouth? Let's find out.
Don't you put it in your mouth. Don't you put it in your mouth. Don't you stuff it in your face. Don't stuff it in your face. Though it might look good to eat. Though it might look good to eat. And it might look good to taste. And it might look good to taste. You could get sick. Ick. Real quick. Ick. Real sick. Real ick. Don't you put it in your mouth. Till you ask someone you love. That's right, sis. If it's okay to eat, if it's okay to eat, like a muffin or a beet,
like a muffin or a beet.
If you don't know just what it is,
remember, boys and girls,
don't put it in your mouth.
Always ask someone you love before you put anything in your mouth.
A message from Concerned Children's Advertisers.
I'm sorry, but it just had to go pretty high on the list. Don't pretend like you don't love it too. I guess it's partially the ironic enjoyment from me, as I think I've probably said before, but there is a lot of genuine enjoyment in here, because I love puppets, even these creepy little bastards. I mean, I know this one backwards and forwards by now. It was one of the first international PSAs that I ever saw. And plus, I covered this one in my musical review, so enough said right there.
There's a lot of stories about the stuff that gets into street drugs. Done to them. Wait till you see what they do to you.
A message from Concerned Children's Advertisers.
All right, let's get the obvious joke out of the way. This needle empty. Yeet! What more needs to be said, really? This is another one of those darker and grittier CCA commercials. It's like an edgy remake of the Needle one from way back earlier on the list. But I like it. Like, heavy drugs, like street drugs, are one of those things that you have to take seriously. And that means amping up the creepy factor a little bit. This one does it just enough that it's not jumping the PSA shark, so to speak. So, yeah, I really like it.
Guess what?
What?
Can you keep a secret?
Maybe. What is it?
Come here. Look.
Wow.
See? Isn't that neat?
What is it?
I don't know, but I found it first, so it's mine.
What's that up there? Is that cheese?
Could be. It sure looks like something to eat, doesn't it? I wonder how this works.
Hey, don't touch it if you don't know what it is.
Why? What's wrong?
Well, I'm not sure. I just think that if we don't really know what it is, we shouldn't touch it. It might hurt us.
Well, then what should we do?
I know that some things are okay and some things are not. And I think if we don't know, we should ask.
Ask who?
Somebody who knows about stuff like this.
Oh, you mean like Mom or Uncle Fred?
Yeah, or somebody else we trust. We don't have to be afraid, but we do have to be careful. Just because somebody leaves something lying around doesn't mean it's okay for us to play with.
Well, I found it, so I get to tell first.
Hey, wait for me. Reach your home.
A message from Concerned Children's Advertisers.
Puppets, yes. The puppetry is pretty good, too. Like, even if the set looks a little dingy and not super appealing, but it's not like it's some big budget TV show. And again, this is clearly meant for little kids, so I'm not judging it as a work of art or anything, even though I do think it's cute and not unbearable to watch, which is more than can be said for some kids' shows. And you know what? I really like the line, some things are okay and some things are not. That's just so vague. I feel like I need to start using it and confuse people.
Here you are. This is the second time. Here, put this on this week. Okay. Be good. I love you.
Coast clear.
Okay. Shh. It's his turn.
I know.
Come on. Go, Rainy. Just let me go. Perfect.
Bring it.
Don't be a chicken.
Bring it.
Do it, man. Do it. Bring it.
Go.
Go on.
Yes. Up the stairs, yeah.
Bring it.
I feel like it's a shame that these flew under the radar so much because what an awesome topic to draw attention to. I could see them making a series out of these, maybe, and pushing it a little bit farther, but unfortunately, I think it is just these two. But have you ever seen a PSA specifically address the social and personal pressures that society puts on boys? I haven't. But it's absolutely true that boys and girls do face different sets of expectations and challenges based on gender conformity rules. And one gender's struggles don't invalidate another's. I feel like that's kind of a huge can of worms to open, so I won't do that right now, but yeah, I'd just like to say these are definitely needed. I just wish they had elaborated a little bit more.
We will not do as we are told. We will not dump our friends just because someone says they're not cool.
We will not be shy when we have something to say.
We will not let boys have all the sports.
We will not be afraid to take on challenges.
We will not go on diets just to look a certain way.
We will not be ashamed of who we are.
We are girls. We will do what's right for us.
Yes, I love this. I am 1000% here for anything that boosts young girls' confidence in themselves and each other. I know it's becoming kind of like outdated to separate genders when it comes to stuff like this, but I think that kids especially need to be told that they're amazing because the fact is, some of them just don't hear it enough. Or at all. If seeing this commercial was some little girl's first instance of feeling empowered as a girl, then that's a wonderful thing. Concerned Children's Advertisers was out there fighting for gender equality all along. Who knew?
Just being yourself. Be a new you in only minutes. Why be you when you can be me?
Your before photograph.
Perfect image package. Ooh, why be you when you can be me?
Step up for your after photograph.
Why let someone else?
So this is kind of a strange one, I'll admit it, but I like it a lot. It's stylized, and it's just a tiny bit creepy, almost like dystopian in a way. I could probably do a lot of analysis on this one if I had the time. Maybe someday I'll do a review of self-image and beauty-based PSAs, but unfortunately I don't think there are a whole lot of those out there. If you know of any, let me know. The message here is clear. Companies are gonna try to profit off your insecurities, and even if they're acting like they care about your best interests, they don't. And nowadays, it goes beyond just companies, because internet influencers exist, and it's hard for your kids to ignore their favorite celebrities giving them advice or recommendations like this. So I do think we could definitely benefit from more PSAs like this today.
Hey, you ever thought about taking drugs?
I don't know.
Well, I never really thought about it.
Think hard. The first hit's free, but you find me when you need more. The choice is yours.
What do you think?
Nah, this jerk's not worth the time.
A message from Concerned Children's Advertisers.
This is a pretty well-known one. It might be even higher if we could understand what these guys were saying. But I mean, who can blame them with those lips? Also, I think we can all agree that that last shot is completely unnecessary, and that's why it's great. Did we need that visual to haunt our dreams? No. Does it make this PSA memorable? Absolutely. Plus, I love this guy who just carries his syringes around in his fingers like that. He's an absolute legend. As I've said before, I consider him part of the PSA cinematic universe.
Your brain is a marvel of technology. But when you take drugs, you alter your brain. You change thinking patterns. You distort perception. And eventually, your brain just won't be the same. Think about it while you still can.
Now this is how you make an impactful drug PSA. No lecturing, no over-the-top shenanigans, just a brutal metaphor that'll be certain to stick with you. I can guarantee you that one thing absolutely nobody wants is brain damage. In fact, I would say people generally go out of their way to avoid it. Also, yep, that's the same narrator from the bag of crack one from earlier. Can we get her to voice more drug PSAs, please?
To stop a friend from using drugs, you may not succeed, but at least you tried, and that's what friends are for.
A message from Concerned Children's Advertisers.
It's the music. That's it. That's what makes this one so great. I mean, it's also really touching and sweet to see this guy supporting his best friend who's going through recovery, and you get the impression of so much that's happened without them saying a single word. And it's just lovely. Am I a sap? Sometimes. And I'm not ashamed to admit it. I'm a simple girl. Terms and conditions may apply. I like a nice reconciliation hug with bittersweet music in the background. Give me that, and you've automatically earned yourself a spot in the top five, at least.
In a kitchen just like yours, all is quiet. Or is it? The North American house hippo is found throughout Canada and the eastern United States. House hippos are very timid creatures and are rarely seen, but they will defend their territory if provoked.
They come out at night to search for food, water, and materials for their nests. The favorite foods of the house hippo are chips, raisins, and the crumbs from peanut butter on toast. They build their nests in bedroom closets, using lost mittens, dryer lint, and bits of string. The nests have to be very soft and warm. House hippos sleep about 16 hours a day.
That looked really real, but you knew it couldn't be true, didn't you? That's why it's good to think about what you're watching on TV and ask questions, kind of like you just did. A message from Concerned Children's Advertisers.
And sliding comfortably into the number one spot, it is my boy, the house hippo. Yes, I really do think this is the CCA's best ad. It's cute, it's clever, and it's just nice to watch. It doesn't get annoying or preachy. I love those little dudes. And it's relatable in that I, too, am a timid creature who spends most of the day in my nest eating peanut butter. Above all, though, this is still a topic that applies today, maybe now more than ever. Kids are crawling over the internet these days, and it's so easy for them to just take certain facts and run with them just because they're presented in a smart-sounding way. And not just kids, but adults, too. Aside from the obvious harm false information causes, it's also the source of so much unnecessary drama. And it frustrates me because it's so simple to just take a page out of our friend the house hippo's book and think for a second, okay, this sounds like it could be true, but I'm not going to pass judgment until I know more. It's a good approach to take in life in general. So that's all of them. That is all the Concerned Children's Advertisers PSAs that I could find spread across the YouTube. This one was pretty interesting because it took forever for me to write out the script for this and like decide where they were all going to go, but I still had some fun doing it, although I do think it's going to be a little while before I do another long list like this. But regardless of that, I hope you guys enjoyed it anyway. I have a special sort of request for my next video. Well, maybe not my next immediately, but a soon-to-be video, possibly in the next 2 weeks or so. I would like to do an AMA and ask me anything. So if you have any questions for me, then leave them in the comments of this video, and I will answer them on video at some point. I think that would be really fun to do, assuming people want to know anything about me. But yeah, that about does it for now. I have a very special thing for you guys for the outro. The amazing Kim, also known as Black Hole Jamie, has made me a subscribe animation for my outro. So, as you know, if you want to make the subscribe happy, hit the subscribe button, turn on notifications and whatnot. Link to my Ko-fi is in the description if you feel like making a donation to help me pay rent, buy for groceries, and eventually upgrade my equipment and whatnot. Maybe I could get a backdrop. I feel like that might be fun. But yeah, I hope you guys have a great day. I will see you next time, and enjoy this new outro. Bye!